Hi, it's Paul from howtoplaybass.com here. Got a quick video lesson for you on how to play the bass line to the tune Chine Girl by David Bowie. Before we get started with the lesson, just a quick reminder for you to head over to my website. The link should be below this video and subscribe to my free monthly e-zine. But let's head over and look at the first part of the lesson, which is the intro. The intro is an 8-bar pattern, which is made up of 2 4-bar patterns that repeat. Play through with the metronome. Metronome set a little slower, then we'll talk through the notes. 2, 3, 4. Okay, so first bar starts on G, which is the 3rd fret of the E string, up to B, 2nd fret of the A string, A, 5th fret of the E string, back to the low G, 3rd fret of the E string, then up to octave G, 5th fret of the D string, and then B and D on the A strings, which is the 2nd and 5th fret. So, and then the 2nd bar is kind of like a variation of that, which is G, B, D, octave G, back to low G. And those fret locations are the same as in the first bar. And then you go up to the 3rd and 4th bars, which are pretty similar. 3rd bar is 4th bar. So the 3rd bar is A, 5th fret of the E string, down to G, 3rd fret of the E string, back to A, and repeat it. Does that again, and then you've got 2 pickup notes before the pattern repeats, which is B and D, 2nd, 5th frets of the A string. And those pickup notes are also used the 2nd time you play through that in the intro, and then you head back to the verse. This pattern's also the outro as well, by the way. So, and it's a pattern that you do have to learn pretty authentically because it fits really nicely with the guitar line that's being played. Okay, let's go and have a look at the verse. The verse is a 16-bar pattern. Play it through the metronome, then we'll talk through the notes. 1, 2, 3, 4. So let's look at that, let's break that down a bit more. The first 8 bars are a 4-bar pattern played twice, where it goes from G to A. Very simple pattern. Start on G, and then when you're going to A, it's 2 bars of G, and then at the end of the 2nd bar when you're going to A, you use the G and then the G sharp before you get to A, the chromatic approach note to A. Okay, and then you're on A. And then you've got that approach note, or approach 2 notes rather, at the end of the 4th bar to go back to G, and those notes are B and D. Same approach notes as are used in the intro pattern. So it repeats that pattern, and then we go on to the 9th bar. We go up to here, which is E at the 7th fret of the A string. 10th bar, play E again, and then you've got this little run down to G, which is D, 5th fret of the A string, B, 7th fret of the E string, A, 5th fret of the E string, then down to G, which is another long note, and then you're going back to A, so you go, got that chromatic note again, and then it models that approach on the next bar of A, with A and A sharp. You get up to B, and then you've got a couple of notes before you end the pattern, which is just B and A. Now, if you correlate that listing of notes with what I played, go back, have a listen, write the notes down, listen to the 16-bar playthrough that I did, you'll figure everything out. Let's move on to the next section, which is kind of like a bridge, and this is the bit, it's kind of like a straight eighth note section, and the lyrics are sort of something about Marlon Brando to start with. So let's go look at that section. Okay, this bridge section, it's a 16-bar section, it's made up of two 8-bar patterns. You've got four notes, just plays eighth notes, root notes. The four root notes are G, 3rd fret of the E string, F, 1st fret of the E string, open E, and D, which is the 5th fret of the A string. I'll just play through 8 bars, so just so you can see it. 2, 3, 4. So that's G, 3rd fret of the E string, F, 1st fret of the E string, E, the open E string, and then up to D at the 5th fret of the A string. And if you know the song at all, you should hear the kind of melody that goes over that section, and the lyric, I think, as I said, something about Marlon Brando. After that section, there's only one more section of the tune to look at, and that's what I've called the riff section. The riff section, you'll recognise it when I play it if you know the song. This section, you can't really put any variations into it because the listener will be, if they know the song, they'll be expecting to hear it. It's kind of like a sub-hook of the tune at that point in time. Let's play through it, then we'll talk through the notes. 3, 4. That section's used under some vocals, it's used under guitar solo as well. So each in the eight bar pattern there are four chords. The first chord's an E chord, and the riff that's played, it's an E minor chord, is E, F sharp, G, B, E, E. So that's the kind of rhythm. Those note locations are open E, F sharp, 2nd fret of the E string, G, 3rd fret of the E string, B, 2nd fret of the A string, back to open E. So it does that twice. Then it goes up to D at the 5th fret of the A string. And then you've got again another nice little chromatic use of a note to walk down to the next chord, which is C. With the D, with the notes on the D, it's important to play them as eighth notes, apart from those last two, so that you get that sense of space in there, help propel the line along. Then you get to the fifth bar of the pattern, which is in C. It's a very similar figure to the E minor pattern, but this is a major chord, so it uses the major third, not a minor third. So it's C, D, 3rd and 5th frets of the A string, E, 2nd fret of the D string, G, 5th fret of the D string, back to C. It does that for two bars, and then you're down to B, and the last two bars are this. So you've got B, which is just the 2nd fret of the A string. Again, you're making those notes staccato to propel the line along, and then that final little rundown to get back into the E minor and the E of the riff is B, 2nd fret of the A string, open A, G, 3rd fret of the E string, F sharp, 2nd fret of the E string. Takes you back to the pattern again. So if you get those four parts down, put them together, play along with the original, you should be able to work your way through Chine Girl. As I said at the top, it's a fun song to play, good for beginners. The more songs you get under the belt, the more confidence you get. So I hope this lesson helps you. If you've got any questions, head over to the website, use the contact form, and send me an email.